Gentlemen, my name is Proka Paravita from ADRI. I am your anchor for the day. I kindly request all to be seated. May I now request Dr. Shaibal Gupta, Member Secretary of ADRI, and Dr. Basudeb Guha Khasnobis, Executive Director of the Center of Health Policy, to please come to the dais. May I request Mr. Suraj from ADRI to please welcome chief guest with the booking. May I request Mr. Rajesh from ADRI to please give welcome to Mr. Sinha with the booking. May I request Mr. Suraj to please welcome Mr. Mahajan with the booking. I now request Mr. Rajesh to please welcome Mr. Dr. Gupta and Dr. Guha with the guest. Thank you, Mr. Suraj, Mr. Rajesh. Let me request Dr. Shaibal Gupta to welcome the guests.
Anjani, Kumar, Singh ji. Chief Secretary, Governor of Bihar, and our chief guest this morning, Sri Shishir, Sinha ji, the Development Commissioner, Sri R.K. Mahajan ji, the Principal Secretary, Department of Health, Dr. P.P. Ghosh, Dr. Khasnobis, other distinguished officials of the state government, colleagues from academic development organization, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of ADRI, I'm delighted to welcome you all today at this consultative workshop on evidence-based research on health in Bihar, which is being organized by Center for Health Policy, a specialized center within ADRI. The CHP has been established recently, about 6 months back in ADRI. You will hear about the objective and agenda of the center from its director very shortly. But I wish to provide you with a brief background that led to the creation of such center. Most of you probably know that since its inception in 1991, ADRI has directed a substantial part of its research agenda towards the development challenges in Bihar. Particularly our attention was on the issue of human development. We also conducted a number of large-scale sample surveys on some social phenomena which were critical, but there was no reliable information based on them. In 2007, the professional interaction between ADRI and the state government was formalized with the establishment of Center for Economic Policy and Public Finance at ADRI, which apart from preparing policy briefs on various development issues, has been responsible for annual economic survey for the state government. This economic survey now provides the most comprehensive database on the state's economy catering to a large number of scholars and development agencies concerned with Bihar. In the context of development research, we should, however, remember that the macroeconomic approach alone cannot meet the research needs of individual sectors. It is only through sectoral approach that the government can identify the sector-specific policies and, more importantly, the specific program and action that can bring about the desired change in the functioning of this sector. Thanks to the initiative of Bill and Melinda Gates, we now have a Center for Health Policy at ADRI, which would help the state government in reforming the health system in Bihar. I may also mention here that there is no dearth of data on health sector in Bihar, be it on health conditions, health practices, or health infrastructure. The state is better poised in that respect compared to many other states. But unfortunately, the rigorous analysis of the available data is rather limited. The CHP plan to bridge that research gap and thereby enable the state government to go that extra mile in fine-tuning policies and interventions. I must also mention here that the efforts of CHP would bear fruits only when center constantly interacts with the stakeholders of the health system, particularly government health functionaries, and today's workshop is a part of that desired interaction process. With that, I once again warmly welcome all of you today and hope your continued engagement with us will lead to a stronger health system in Bihar. Let us look forward to productive consultation throughout the course of the day. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Gupta. Let me request Dr. Basudeb Guha Khasnobis to introduce CHP and the day's agenda.
Thank you, Pragya. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Center for Health Policy, I wish to convey my sincere gratitude to all of you for attending today's workshop. I am Basudeb Guha Khasnobis, the director of CHP, a role which I assumed on August 1st, 2017, after working for more than 15 years at the United Nations in many different countries. CHP is set up with funding from the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. We are not an isolated unit, but we are meant to complement a range of other initiatives under the leadership of the government of Bihar to strengthen the health systems and health outcomes of the state. Some of these initiatives are in partnership with various other development partners. So in that regard, we also look forward to collaborating with a range of such partners. The main way in which we would be able to add value is by analyzing the wealth of data which are available both from national level surveys as well as those generated locally. Our research will be driven entirely by data, both quantitative and qualitative, and at times, a combination of the two. We deliberately delayed our formal appearance before you because we wanted to come to you with some concrete work. Today, we are ready to share what we have been doing over the past 4 months, and most importantly, seek your feedback on the same. With your kind permission, I wish to introduce my team Let me request them to please come forward as I call out the names. Arundhati Char. Shashwat Ghosh. Sanchita Mahapatra. Vikas Keshri. Apurva Srishti. This is my small but highly dedicated team, and you will hear from all of them about their work during the day. All of us will be meeting with our counterparts in government on a regular basis to establish our future work plans. So please memorize their names, their faces. We have a packed schedule today. I'm afraid at times it might give you a sense of the work being technical. To be honest, some of it is indeed technical, but we have kept the technicalities to the barest minimum and will be presenting only the key messages which emerged. Having said that, we will be happy to get into the details of our technical analysis, for example, with the research fraternity whom we have invited, and also otherwise. It is part of our work to strengthen the research capacity within the state. On the day's agenda, we have completed a thorough analysis of morbidity and health-seeking behavior in Bihar, looking at the changes that occurred during 2004 to 2014. It enabled us to evaluate, for example, the effects of NRHN, JSY, and various insurance schemes on a range of issues, including institutional delivery, out-of-pocket expenditure, hospitalization, to name only a few. Based on these trends that we have observed, future planning will require a comprehensive understanding of the district-wise demographic profile of the state, including some future projections. This has also been done. Our findings on out-of-pocket expenses point to the need for state's stewardship in addressing possible market failures in the health sector. In this context, we shall speak about regulation. Given the high fertility rate of the state, compared to others, and consequently a fast-growing population, reproductive and maternal health are critical areas which will continue to demand attention, and we have looked into this aspect. We have addressed a relatively uncharted territory, that of mental health. It is emerging as a leading non-communicable disease and has repercussions on many other aspects at the individual, family, and societal levels. Above all, it has a strong human rights normative attached, which we wish to highlight. Last but not the least, there will be a discussion on the role of information technology in delivering better healthcare. We have noted, however, that technology alone cannot replace a conventional health system. It can only strengthen it. I must stop here with the hope that with your support, feedback, and continuous engagement, in the days to come, CHP will be seen as a trusted research partner of the government of Bihar. Thank you.
For introducing us to CHP and also the day's agenda. May I now request Principal Secretary Health, Mr. R. K. Mahajan, to give his address.
Respected Chief Secretary, respected Development Commissioner, Dr. Shaibal Gupta, Dr. Basudeb Guha, Executive Director, Center for Health Policy, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I will congratulate Dr. Shaibal Gupta for taking this initiative by organizing consultative workshop by the Center for Health Policy. This center has been set up to help the health department and health sector in general. How we can improve the health services in Bihar and in which ways we can improve our delivery system. For your knowledge, for last 10-15 years, there is a significant improvement in various health indicators in the state. For example, in the year 2005, only 39 patients were visiting our health facility per month. Now this number has gone up more than 10,000 patients per month per health facility. Similarly, in infant mortality rate, maternal mortality rate, and TFR also, our achievement is very, very significant. In Kalazar, our target is to eliminate Kalazar in the state in the year 2018. In immunization, our coverage is around 84%, and our target is to achieve 90% coverage by the end of December 2018. That's our target, and we are going to achieve the target. There is an improvement in health sector in various areas, various health indicators, but still we have to go a long way. We are having challenges. Major challenge for us is shortage of doctors, especially specialist doctors. There is a tremendous shortage of specialist doctors in the health sector. In spite of best efforts, we are unable to have the doctors and post them. Even if we post them, we recruit the doctors, they are not willing to go to the rural areas. That's the biggest challenge for us. So we are unable to provide the specialist service in the rural areas. We have to find a solution to that. Second challenge for us is to improve the work culture in the government facilities. Although we have doctors, paramedical staff, but work culture is lacking. How to motivate our doctors and paramedical staff to provide best service to the patients? That is also a big challenge for us. There are so many challenges, but these are the major challenges for us. And we are working on to solve these challenges. But if Center for Health Policy can help us in providing solution to meet these challenges, that will go a long way. There are so many other things, like delivery system is very poor in the rural areas. How to improve our various services, how to take various measures, the preventive health. Preventive health is another area in which we are lacking. So Center for Health Policy can help us in improving the preventive health system in the state. These are the major area of the concerns for which we need your assistance. And I assure Center for Health Policy and ADRI Health Department will provide all the cooperation which will be required to the center in doing its research and finding solution to the our problems. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mahajan. I now request Development Commissioner Mr. Kumar Sinha to give his address.
Respected Chief Secretary, my esteemed colleague, R.K. Mahajan sir, Shaibal Gupta ji, my head of the CHP, Center for Health Policy, Mr. Guha, my colleagues from the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and from ADRI. First of all, I would like to congratulate and thank both Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and ADRI for setting up such a good state-of-the-art Center for Health Policy. I was going through the profile of the faculty and I was very impressed. They are all erudite, highly qualified, and that is what a center is always, the standard of a center is, judged by the type of faculty they have. So I think, again, hats off to Shaibal Gupta ji for getting such a erudite faculty, and I wish, I hope that this faculty is going to guide us, state of Bihar in the future. As my colleague just now mentioned, we are having great hope and expectation from the Center for Health Policy, because Bihar government for the last 10, 12, 13 years, the present government, they have been going for health reforms, trying all types of interventions, stage one, stage two, but I think what we expected, the outcome what we expected, we have not been able to achieve it. Now with the CHC fully functional, CHP, we'll be in a position to get mid-course results, outcomes, you know, various policy interventions, policy which we have formulated for providing better health to the people of Bihar. If it has not been able to give the desired results, we'll be in a position with the feedback which we get from the center, empirical study data. Like recently, we have come to know that the infant mortality rate of Bihar has really come down by 4 points. But there is an alarming factor that there is a great disparity between the male and the female, the girl child. It's nearly double. So that also we have to know what all interventions are required to ensure that this gap between the mortality rate of a girl child and a male child is brought down. Same is the case with the fertility rate has come down, the replacement rate has come to 3.4, but still it's the highest in the country. Now there also, I think government is aware of one, I think what the government has planned and what it's trying to implement is that if the girls are educated to the high school, every panchayat should have a girls high school, and if the girls get educated at least to the 10 plus 2, then I think that is going to impact on our replacement rate, and the replacement rate will come down closer to the national average. Now, out of pocket expenses, we said only yesterday, a gentleman from Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation told me that our neighbor Sri Lanka has a very good health system and there is no out of pocket expense out there. And he gave me an example that when they were visiting Sri Lankan hospitals, one remote hospital, the doctor came and reported to the hospital authority that a patient needed a certain medicine within 2 hours, otherwise the patient will be dead. Now there also they didn't ask the patient or his relative to get the medicine from the market. Within 1 hour the medicine was organized, it was made available, and the patient survived. So there also we want to have it. It's not only out of pocket expenses, the type of facilities which we should provide, there also we need improvement. And most important point which the health system in Bihar is facing is primarily the shortage of human resource. Whether it's doctor, nurses, technical staff, there's a huge shortage, and in spite of our various incentives which we are providing, like 1 lakh rupees for, or even now 1,25,000 for specialists, in spite of that we are not getting specialists, doctors. And in addition to that, the training of our health cadre. There also Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, they came in with nurse mentoring, which has given us good results. We expect that this mentoring process at all level, if that continues, and we would expect the center also to guide us, to tell us that how we can fine-tune our interventions, the policy formulation, in order to get the maximum output from whatever input we are already providing, and we should graduate into our phase two, because we have yet to achieve our phase one reforms, the results of phase one reforms. So we will be in a position to graduate to phase two and see to it that there also whatever we have targets which we have set up, we are able to achieve. Thank you.
May I now request our chief guest, Chief Secretary, Government of Bihar, Mr. Anjani Kumar Singh, to please give his keynote address.
My colleagues and friends, you all know that Bihar is spending a huge amount for social interventions, both in education and health. We are one of the largest spender on social sector in the country. Almost 30-35% of our total resource goes to social sector. That is a deliberate policy because we realize that Bihar's strength is human resource. If we are able to develop this resource, many of our problems will be solved, and that will be the right way of developing or growing fast. Our problem is not that much of policy, but more of implementation. We have realized, and in last 10 years, from our experience, by now we know what we have to do in which sector, but schemes are made, but when it is implemented, then there are serious problems. We also have research organizations. We also have a department called Planning Department, which every year does a dozen of researches, but most of those researches are either evaluation studies or some very basic type of things which does not really give you some real input for policy formulation or correction in policies. So I hope with this Center for Health Policy, now we will get some real input which will help us in correcting our schemes, taking timely interventions and changing some policies also. Like, you know, we have spent a lot of money for girl child. If you see right from the beginning, there was a positive discrimination for girl child. We started with dress scheme, then cycle, then a scholarship, midday meal, free textbook, etc. And social welfare department also started many schemes. If a girl is born in a family, they get something. Young girl, she gets a deposit which matures in 21 years. When she gets married, there is some scheme which helps her. All these interventions have resulted into better enrollment and better presence in our school system, but not in our hospitals. If you see the hospital data, the female who are accessing this facility is still 20-22%. It is in school, if you go to any school, you will see girls are more than 50%. So now, in fact, government is planning and thinking that we may have to declare one day a week only as a female day for the hospitals. Somehow, the girl child is not taken by the family to the hospital for small ailments or even serious ailments. So there has to be some way of persuading them that they also require same treatment as the boys. I'll give you some examples where with good intentions things have started, but then you have problems. When this government came, we thought that health services should go to the villages. So there was a great emphasis on creating primary health centers and health sub-centers. So this health department started making building of health sub-centers. We made, I don't know, many hundreds of health sub-centers, but then we suddenly realized that we don't have doctors, we don't have paramedics, we don't have the equipment. So by only spending money and assuming that the facility will reach to villages did not prove true. Because we had to plan, but again the problem is even if you plan for doctors, you are not getting doctors. And if you are getting doctors, you are not getting lady doctors and you are not getting specialist doctors. So when we go to our this district yatra as with Chief Minister, many places the demand is we don't have a lady doctor, so how that childbirth can take place in hospitals. So everybody is demanding a lady doctor, and a lady doctor does not want to go to a health sub center or a primary health center. She wants to be in a district headquarter or district hospital. So how this thing will match? Because there is a scheme which says that all births should take place in the hospitals. But how to implement that? You don't have that doctor. Again, you don't have that specialist doctor. Every time health department is increasing their honorarium or salary, and now perhaps it is 1,20,000. Still we are not getting. Though people are, 300 people are recruited, only 50 are reporting. So these are our implementation problems. The resource is not a problem. Policy is not a problem. Intention is not a problem. Will is not a problem. How to implement in our given condition? We should have realized that before taking health facility to health sub-center, it is better to strengthen our primary health center and district hospital. So that time you should have taken that route. First you strengthen your district hospitals, then go to primary health center, then you think of health sub-centers when you have sufficient doctors, sufficient paramedic personnel. Then there are some new areas which is emerging that on which we would like the center to work. The areas which has become very recently for last 1 year, we have realized that we have a huge stunted population. Mental health and disability. Disability again, rehabilitation part is now for last 5-6 years because of some intervention from social welfare department, we are able to give them aids and appliances. But we are not able to go beyond that. And we are not able to prevent disability. So that is one area where we have to work because that number is becoming sizable. Mental health is another area. Stunting is something like 38%, 39%. 48%. 48%. So these are new areas for which we don't have real good scheme. So in the end, my request will be, when you are doing research, our implementation issues should also be addressed. And if you give, like another example I'll give you, like Government of India said, all benefits to people should go through DBT, direct bank transfer. Looks very nice, ideal that leakage will go, and money will reach directly to the beneficiary. But in Bihar, it is not happening. Why it is not happening? People are not accustomed to bank accounts. Drawing money or using net or those facilities to take money or deposit money. So they are dependent on that bank correspondent. People are illiterate, so that bank correspondent goes to that beneficiary and says that 2,000 rupees has come. Really 4,000 has been transferred to the account. But the person is illiterate, does not know, so see, he takes a thumb impression and pays 2,000 rupees. So earlier, in a manual system, the leakage was 10%. Now the leakage is 30%. Though the scheme is very nice, direct bank transfer is a very nice scheme. You are assuming that everybody is knowing how to deposit money and how to take money, and bank is very accessible. You can go anytime, take your money, you will know that money has been deposited in your account, but they are not knowing. So in this last 6-7 districts that we visited very recently, that came as a very serious problem. All our pension schemes, all our Vridhavastha pension scheme, Viklang pension scheme, Vidwa pension scheme, the beneficiary is real old illiterate people. So there, that DBT may not be the right solution. So that will come through research only. What type of other interventions we will have to put, how to make them aware, maybe some way we will have to find some way so that people are informed that such and such money has come to your account for that purpose. So once they know, then they will demand that not 2,000, 4,000 has come. So many schemes, because it's a pan-India scheme, so when you try to implement that scheme in rural area in a different locations, things are different. So that is another area I wanted you to indicate, and in the end, health, the resource is not a problem, And now we have good officers also, both at our infrastructure corporation as well as our project, State Health Society. I think we are ready for second level improvements. That first level improvement, of course, took place. Earlier, people were not going to our primary health centers. That number used to be 30, 40. Now it is in hundreds. So that is a good sign. People are going. Medicines are available. Not all medicines are available, but sufficient number of medicines are available. So that those type of things have happened. For next generation reforms, will require your support. Thank you.